السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear brothers and sisters, الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الحمد لله, all praises due to Allah. Ramadan, day 5, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to fast, to pray, and to carry out as many hasanat before the month of Ramadan departs. Now that the month of Ramadan is here, people react differently to the coming of the month of Ramadan. You have a category who exhibit clear signs of displeasure. They're not happy. The month of Ramadan is here. It's going to affect their weight, it's going to affect their work, their sleeping patterns, and perhaps it is a minority, but they do exist. You have a second category who are kind of somewhere in the middle. I mean, they're not overly excited, they're not disappointed, they're doing what everyone else is doing. It's part of the process of being a Muslim, and it's the same situation every year. But then you have a third category, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from this category. A blessed group of people who are so excited that the month of Ramadan is here, and they don't want it to depart. And their slogan in life is, Ramadan, stay with us. Ramadan, don't leave us. Ramadan, our hearts are so ill and sins are so heavy. Imagine a guest, dear brothers and sisters, that comes, visits you, and then the moment that guest leaves, you notice that the house has been clean, tidy. Everything has been polished. In fact, not just that, there were certain structural damages in your home that could have damaged your life. Had they continued, he had even fixed them all before leaving. Subhanallah. How would you feel towards such a guest? And this is essentially the month of Ramadan. A guest that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends to us once a year. And when that guest leaves, it has cleaned up our sayyi'at, our sins, taking it all away from us, sins that would have otherwise jeopardized our dunya and affected our journey to Allah in the hereafter as well. They're very happy now that the month of Ramadan is here, and they're in no rush for it to leave. And that is because they know that the opportunity of having your sins erased in the month of Ramadan is very much connected to a mentality, an intention. Focus with me on these three narrations, brothers and sisters. من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever fasts the month of Ramadan out of belief and hope in the reward, this person will have his sins forgiven. Look at the conditions. Narration number two. من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever prays the night prayer in the month of Ramadan out of belief and hope in the reward, look at the conditions, his sins will be erased. Narration number three. من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever prays the night prayer of ليلة القدر, the night of decree, out of belief and hope and the reward, their sins will be erased. And so this third category of people are very keen to show Allah Almighty enthusiasm and happiness and excitement with the hunger and the thirst, because they know that their sins will be erased and it is connected to a mentality, an intention. Brothers and sisters, our fasting, our praying is not because other people are doing it, whether they are there or whether they are not, whether they encourage us, whether they don't. We are planning to fast the month of Ramadan and to pray in hope for the erasing of our sins. Oh Allah, be our witness that we are happy that you have gifted us with the month of Ramadan. So we ask you to erase our sins through this love. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد والحمد لله رب العالمين.